Hey guys, I'm going to show you today how you can take a single color, typically black and white, cut file and create colors within it. And so we're going to do it a few times so you can see how it's done. And we're going to start with this geometric unicorn. This is from the Silhouette Design Store. It is design ID number 211949. You can see here. And so this is how it comes straight from the store. And so what we want to do is we want to make this into like a stained glass, and I want to cut different pieces out of different colors. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to copy and paste or duplicate. You can use your keyboard shortcuts, Command C on a Mac, Control C on a PC, and then it would be V for paste, Command V or Control V. But I'm just going to right click and duplicate, and then I'm going to move this extra one off to the side for a minute. And so I want to take this one back to transparent. And so I'm just going to take the color out of that. Let's go ahead and open our fill menu here so we'll have it. And what I want to do is I want to right click and release compound path. And that's going to make each one of these shapes its own separate identity. And in order to have just these shapes, we're going to delete the outer cut line. So now we're just left with the inside. And each one again is its own separate entity, as you can see. So we're just going to randomly click some, and I'm going to hold down the shift key while I select the shapes so that it will keep the ones selected previously. Keep those selected, and I'm going to group them together so that I can change the color of all of them at the same time, should I want to. And then let's click a few more. Let's do. And I'm just randomly picking. You can choose to not group them so that you can change random ones on their own later, if that's what you want to do. It's totally up to you how you want to group. I like to keep things grouped together. It's easy enough to ungroup them. And let's add this one into that. And, again, it's personal preference. We're going to group it all together at the end. Again, that's just personal preference. And let's do this color. So now we have them all colored in, and I'm just going to group them so that nothing gets out of place. And then I'm going to drag this back over, and I'm going to use the keyboard, the arrow keys, the left, right, up, and down to nudge my outline so that it lines up, and you can see that we've lined everything up. And so now you could do this for a print and cut. You could do the registration boxes if you like to use those to layer. You could layer this with adhesive vinyl. You could cut it in separate pieces to use for heat transfer vinyl. You could cut it out of cardstock. You could do anything you wanted with it. And as long as you just select everything to resize it together, then you're able to do that. And make sure you check out the layering videos that I have on my YouTube channel, ElleBeeCreates.com. I do show how to create the registration boxes to make layering adhesive vinyl really easy. I do have a layering heat transfer vinyl tutorial, so those are there for you if you need them. But yep, that's pretty cool. Let's move on to another one. This is the Unicorn Flower Crown from the Silhouette Design Store, design 201230. And again, this one comes in as just a solid color, nothing fancy to it, and we want to make this into a pretty floral crown. So again, as it is, this is what you get. And you could use this as a coloring page or something like that, but we want to add some color. So what I'm going to do is, let's take that color back out. I'm going to right click, duplicate, and then move this extra one off to the side. I'm going to come back to our crown, right click, release compound path, and then we can delete that outer area and then just select the items that you want to change their color. So we want to do a silver horn and then throw in some color here. And you can select multiple pieces by holding down the shift key as you select them. If you accidentally select something you didn't mean to, just select it again and it'll unselect it. So you can just go around to your different pieces and pick your colors. And I'm just kind of randomly picking. Sometimes you're able to draw and select everything. And so you can do that. This one here reminds me of a sunflower for some reason. Change that one up. Take the insides of these. I'm going to make them all the same color. And then we just have a few more flowers here. Select the pieces that you want, and you don't have to make the one flower all the same color. You can do it whatever you desire. And then I'm just going to select everything, right click and group it. And again, you can use keyboard shortcut of Command or Control V, depending on if you're PC or Mac. And then let's turn this black so it's easier to see. Line it up. And then again, I like to use my arrow keys to nudge things into place. And there we go. Now we have a, we went from this over here with no color to this with a colorful crown. So this will look really cool with some holographic or metallic vinyl here for the horn. And then let's do, we'll do one more. This is I Heart Tacos, again from the Silhouette Design Store. Design number 213370. And I'm using Silhouette Design Store files because everybody has access to those. If you are a designer and you have a file that you want me to use, just let me know. You can contact me at media@lbcreates.com. But the Silhouette Design Stores is something that's easy for everybody to get. And so I'm using these. And this one's grouped together. We're going to right click, ungroup, so we can change the color of these. So for this heart, it's red already. Let's make it pink so you can see the cut lines. And so if you wanted it as an outline like that, that's cool. If you wanted to make it a two-tone, you could duplicate, move it over here, right click, release compound path, and now you see this inner piece, and we could change the color of that. Well, we have to select it first. You could change the color of that there, so you could have a two-tone, or you can just right-click, release compound path, and you can delete the inner one out if you want it as a solid color heart, whatever look you're going for. And then we have the taco. So again, we're going to right-click, duplicate, move that extra one over here, right-click, release compound path. Oh, and this one is not. Oh, we'll see. Ungroup. So there we go. We had to release the compound path and ungroup. And it all just depends on the order that the designer does it in when they're making the file. So they're kind of undoing what they did. Let's take out all these little circles. Just going to select them. You can also drag. Or again, hold down the shift key so you can select multiple. So this would be the shell, and then I think this would probably be lettuce. This could be maybe beef, maybe cheese. You can do it, it's cool. I mean, you can do it however you want. That would be the inside of the shell, and then we'll turn this outline black and bring it back over. And you could, I mean, you could go so far as the dots that we deleted earlier on. You could make those a darker shade of your shell. Do it however you wanted. Use those arrow keys to nudge it back into place. And voila, there you have your I Heart Tacos. And I think that's pretty easy. And so let's go back here and revisit this for a minute. So what we have, if we were going to cut this, is we have what I refer to as like a stained glass effect, is this piece is cut out and then each color is going to lay within. And so it's not actually going to be a layered, it's more pieced together because you don't actually have two pieces of material stacked on top of one another. But sometimes you want to do that. Especially if you're doing heat transfer vinyl, you do get a little bit of shrinkage and you can get a gap in between those. So it just depends. Even with adhesive vinyl, by not having it like that, you can run the risk of getting it off just slightly and having a gap. So let me show you another option. We're going to make this transparent again. Right click and release compound path. And then instead of deleting the outside, we're going to get rid of the inside. So let's just select all of that. Not that. And we're just going to move this over here. And if you take this, make it black, and then let's right click and send it back. And so now it's behind. So it's the same effect, but instead of having a stained glass piece together, you actually have a layer, and it's just two layers. You have the black on the bottom, and then these color pieces would go on top. But again, it's just a slightly different approach and a different way to do it. And then, of course, you would just get rid of that. So I just wanted to throw another option out there. Same thing would go for this. You could just, let's copy that and right, well, just make it transparent first so we can see everything. Release compound path. Keep that. Let's get rid of everything else. Get rid of all of this. Get rid of all of this. And then this we would turn black. We'll send to the back. And then, so we'll get rid of that and bring this in. So it's the same result that you get either way. Let me show you something. Let's do this. Let's copy and paste. And I'm going to delete the black. So side by side, what you have here is one of them has a solid black background, and the other one is just an outline. So it just depends on what you're going for, if you want to go for the outline or if you want to go for the solid back. Either way, your finished look is the same. As you can see, looking at them side by side, you can't even tell which one's which. So if you have any questions, as always, let me know, and tell me what you think. Love to hear it. Thanks, guys.